You are about to see what happens inside a military Humvee when it rolls over. A government report released earlier this year found Humvees, the most common military vehicle, are involved in more Army and Marine Corps accidents than any other tactical vehicle. What's more, many of these crashes happen in non-combat situations. This morning, see why advocates are calling for changes to help save the lives of service members. A warning, some of this footage may be difficult to watch.
The impact is jarring. You're watching a crash simulation involving a military Humvee. 10,000 pounds of metal traveling at just 25 miles an hour, rolling over twice after hitting a ramp. A sobering example of what can happen in combat and during routine training.
We knew it was bad, but nobody thought that Wes wasn't going to make it.
Abby Kuby is the widow of Staff Sergeant Wesley Kuby. In June, her husband was on a training mission at the Smoky Hill Air National Guard Range. He died after the Humvee he was riding in rolled over. Abby is now raising their three children.
I didn't actually get to be with him or say goodbye.
The investigation into what caused the accident is still ongoing, but Kuby's death is not isolated. According to the Government Accountability Office, there were more than 3,700 tactical vehicle accidents from 2010 to 2019 in non-combat situations. Almost a third involved Humvees. At least 123 service members were killed, contributing to what Congress calls a trend of non-war-related deaths in the military. The report also found that nearly 25% of the accidents involved a rollover. Military experts say the armor added to Humvees makes them prone to rollovers. 2 years ago, the Army contracted advanced safety supplier IMMI to research and test safety solutions for the Humvee. NBC News was invited to IMMI's crash test demonstration for a look at how additional safety measures could help service members survive.
I'm here in Indiana, and joining me now is Nick Awabdi. He's the lead engineer here at IMMI. Nick, we're standing in front of this Humvee. It's specially equipped. What do you expect to see today?
So we're going to induce a rollover, which simulates a real-world scenario, and we'll see how our technology will help a service member in a crash over a conventional three-point seatbelt.
Engineers install sensors and rig the Humvee with 30 cameras to capture every angle inside and outside the vehicle. Inside the Humvee, both test dummies are belted. The passenger in the back is wearing a standard seatbelt, and the driver is wearing IMMI's Embrace technology, a four-point seatbelt system that deploys an airbag and pulls the driver down to create space between their head and the ceiling.
Launching vehicle in 3, 2, 1.
Traveling at 25 miles an hour.
Okay, here it comes.
The Humvee hits a ramp designed to simulate what could happen in a real-life rollover. The Humvee flips twice, almost jumping the barricade. And on the inside, chaos. Watch as this rider wearing just a standard seatbelt is thrown from side to side. In slow motion, you can see the rider's head hit the ceiling with every roll. But not the driver. The airbag and the four-point seatbelt protect the driver's head and neck.
Nick, that was incredible to see in person. We saw what happened on the outside. What happened on the inside?
Yeah, so everything worked just as planned.
Okay.
And then the entire seat was pulled to the floor, opening up survivable space
for the service member. And that protects their head.
And that protects the head and neck from coming in contact with the roof.
In addition to IMMI's technology, the Army is exploring other safety solutions, including better driver training and the use of simulators to build driver experience. But for families who've lost service members, the changes are long overdue.
I never really realized it was a problem. But now that I'm, I guess you could say, kind of living a nightmare, that is a problem. And it is frustrating.
So sad for that family. That demonstration was just troubling, just watching that. So this is new to us, but it's not necessarily new to the military?
No, it's not, Tom. This has been a known problem since at least 2014, when a military report found blunt force trauma in Humvee crashes to be especially fatal. Now, some have been equipped with anti-lock brakes and stability control systems by Ricardo Defense. But when it comes to the technology that you're looking at right there, IMMI says installing that Embrace system will cost between $4,000 to $5,000 per vehicle. Humvee maker AM General, they were also at that demonstration. They say they do support IMMI's research to make their Humvees safer.
All right, Vicky, thank you for that.